time for the final exhibition, the main event here tonight at a bonanza of body slams. And Judge Hugo Lexington Black is on his way to the ring, but from what I've been told, Inky Scoots handed me some notes. It appears that the judge is back in the wheelchair. At the extravaganza, Chuck Taylor poured hooch on the judge, which caused a miraculous cure, and the judge was walking with no issues. However, after the El Paso kid Gregory Iyer jumped from the top of the cage, the judge claimed that his legs are injured again and that they are not working properly. I don't know.
Get my chair. What are you
doing? I can't believe the judge is going to attempt to win the World Heavyweight Championship from Matthew Cross here tonight in Muncie, Indiana. The referees helped Gavin Volstead get Judge Hugo Lexington Black into the ring, and now we're going to attempt to get the wheelchair of the judge in the ring as well. Judge Hugo seems to be the only politician not really upset that Prohibition is ending. I mean, after all, sorry, I was distracted by what I'm seeing here in the squared circle. A man in a wheelchair. And he is going to attempt to win the World Championship from Matthew Cross. A man who has surpassed some of the great champions in history. He has surpassed the reign of Ed Strangler Lewis, George Hackenschmidt, and as of today, is approximately 700 days away breaking Frank Gotch's record as being a world champion. The judge is waiting on the arrival of our world heavyweight champion, Matthew Cross, a man who is a specimen, a man who is a physical specimen unlike any other in the grappling arts. And the judge wants him to come out, wants Matthew Cross to get out here right away. And we are still waiting on Matthew Cross. Ah! I believe here he comes now. The man that is the world champion. There you see all of his championship belts. Matthew Cross is certainly one of the best. Well, he is the best. Not one of. He is the best wrestler in the world today. You see it right there. For those here in attendance at Muncie, you see it right there as he has all the title belts. I wonder what his strategy will be tonight to defeat the man in the wheelchair. The man that, quite frankly, is a little bit of a hypocrite because rumor is that he dabbled with a little hooch in his sweet tea that he is so fond of.
10, 30, 40 pounds of gold.
40 pounds of gold is what Matthew Cross just said. Is what his championship belt weigh. There you go. Matthew Cross, a man who is a great grappler and doesn't do it for the love of the sport. He doesn't do it for the dough. He does it because he enjoys wrestling and he enjoys entertaining his fans. Fans certainly do appreciate him here in Muncie, Indiana.
And now, ladies and gentlemen,
showing all the title belts to the challenger. Hugo, right now, he is taking one of them and is putting it around his waist. I am curious to how the judge is going to get a victory if he is in the wheelchair. Here we go. The referee getting more of the championship belts from Matthew Cross. And now the referee comes to the ring. To the center of the ring. He gives his final instructions. There's the bell. And where I just said that the last match was probably the most bizarre thing I've ever called, this will certainly be it. This is 2 out of 3 falls as a standard for a world championship match of this caliber. And again, we are at 49 body slams. We said in many of our posters and our flyers that we would have 50 or more body slams. Man hesitant. Cross is not sure exactly what they can do.
This is my life.
Just threw Matthew Cross right into the bullseye. his foot back into the, I believe, stirrup there of the wheelchair. Matthew Cross must be back in the squared circle. The referee is counting. If he reaches the end of his count, then Matthew Cross is not back in. Oh my!
Thank you.
stuck at 49. We would love to have 50. That's what we promised the fine folks of Muncie. A series of clubbing blows from Jet Ball now. Using the top rope as a weapon. And using the bottom rope as a weapon. Judge is very, very, very astute in using the ring as his weapon and still trying to figure out how to use his legs. Still not quite sure how to use his legs. Now he must thank Dr. Jacob Holman for the elixir to get him back in to this match. And now the judge picking up Matthew Cross. Again, there's a big kick to the midsection. I am still somewhat concerned about what would happen. What if the unthinkable happened? What if the judge wins the world championship? Clubbing blow from the judge on Matthew Cross. And another clubbing blow. And a third blow to the back of Matthew Cross again. And the judge running out of the room. And he goes over the top of the top rope. And now what is Matthew Cross going to do? Another double sledge. And Matthew Cross now is going to climb the top rope there. Fans calling for body slam, but another double sledge. That might be enough. A one, a two, and that's all. You see?